I'm going to be discussing the final scene of Agnes Varda's final film, Faces Places, which she directed with JR. I'm going to begin by saying JR is a very famous young contemporary social activist outdoor artist. He puts large images of people onto walls all over the world. And he's very hip. He just shot Madonna's image for the front of the New York Times Magazine. He partners with Agnes Varda on the film. They make the film together and they're the stars of the film. So you see both of them throughout the whole film. And they're traveling around France together. Literally, he's driving a van. It has a big camera eye on the side. They stop in a town that they decide to go to and they take pictures of people in the town and then they talk to people in the town and then they put huge images of those people onto a building in the town. It's very beautiful. And they have these sparse and very elegant and very warm interactions between the two of them.
Agnès, t'es en Normandie, dans une des plus vieilles régions de France, et tu veux aller sur les maisons les plus moches du coin.
Mais c'est pas moche quand on commence.
That are intercut between these sparse and elegant and warm interactions that they have with people around France.
Bah, c'est une bonne collaboration. D'ailleurs, je voulais vous demander comment vous étiez rencontrés.
Sur un site de rencontre mythique.
Comme quoi?
Bah, c'est une blague, j'aime pas cette blague. Parce que je suis pas mystique du tout. Je suis dans la vie.
So towards the end of the film, as the film is reaching its climax, he takes a photograph of her toes and her eyes and puts them onto the trains. Taking the photograph of her eyes is very important because there's an ongoing theme across the film about seeing and being seen. So her eyes don't work very well. So we actually see her eyes getting a surgery, and he has covered his eyes with glasses. And they have an ongoing interaction about she wants to see his eyes, he won't let her.
Mais tu as encore ces foutues lunettes. Moi, je pense que ce n'est pas amical. C'est comme si tu tendais un voile noir entre nous.
And it's backed up by the fact that at the very beginning of their careers, when Godard and Agnès Varda were young people and friends, and they were making this goofy little movie, which is her first movie, he, who also wore dark glasses, takes off his glasses. There's a parallel that's being drawn, JR and Godard, and a parallel being drawn about seeing and being seen and looking at eyes and seeing through eyes. So in the scene before the one I'm about to show you, directly in front of it, gentleman kind of worker, he says to her, I'm curious, why did you put toes on trains? Is there a point? And then she answers,
c'est le pouvoir de l'imagination.
D'accord.
C'est-à-dire qu'on se donne le droit, JR et moi, d'imaginer des choses et de demander aux gens, est-ce qu'on peut faire notre imagination chez vous? Par contre, notre idée toujours, c'était d'être avec les gens qui travaillent. Donc c'est pour ça qu'on a fait les photos de groupe. Donc il y a en même temps un désir de partager avec vous les photos de groupe et puis de faire nos petites idées, nos petites folies, ce qui nous fait plaisir. En espérant que ça fait plaisir aux autres.
D'accord.
Aussi.
Bon, ce qui me surprenait, c'est que c'est original et puis c'est une autre expérience.
So again, you can see encapsulated in her very short description of what they're doing, a lot of what I already said, that they're interested in JR and Agnès Varda pressing what we can do with our imaginations against or into the real world. So we see that literalized, like her toes and her eyes traveling through France. That's an imagination pressed against reality. They're very interested in exchanging with other people. So the film has been about literally their exchange, and by that I mean interaction, talking.
Merci d'être venu. Je dis bonjour aux jeunes.
Bah oui, parce qu'ils sont à ta taille.
But also an exchange of sort of gifts across France. So they meet people, we see them talk to people. They take a picture, they give them back the picture into their community, it goes up onto the wall, and they leave this beautiful monument of the exchange. But it's also about the exchange between JR and Agnes, which is visually stunning in its simplicity. He's tall and skinny, and she's round and short. He's young and exuberant. He likes to do parkour, so there's lots of shots of him like running around and jumping around and being so mobile in the world. And she is in a wheelchair or with a cane, and he's a male and she's a female. And issues of gender and the power of gender within cinema and looking is a theme of all of her films and a theme of this film as well. So the exchange between the two of them is extremely important. And then this idea that there's joy in making cinema.
On est bien ici, non? Voilà, on peut faire notre machin là, et hop, on est tranquille. On est dans la planète.
And interacting through cinema and pleasure is very much enacted in the final scene, but across their adventure. So that it isn't like any road movie. It isn't just that they are having fun on the road. They're having fun on the road and filming it. Because they are filming it, they can have fun on the road. The power of cinema to allow them to move in the world and give them permission to move in the world and interact with each other is extremely important for this scene. And that's the difference between documentary and narrative filmmaking. In this kind of documentary, we understand that a film is being made. It doesn't pretend that a film is being made. It's actually about the fact that a film is being made, and the film is initiating the pleasure. So if you think about Jean-Luc Godard's Abou Tessoufla, the road trip that they go on, that is also an homage to cinema and the pleasures of cinema. But it's not quite as overt as Agnès and JR's trip.
Oui, avec la grosse lame de rasoir. Voilà.
Alors, y a l'œil, et puis ça fait comme ça. La piqûre, c'est de la bricole. Une
piqûre. Tu veux pas t'asseoir un petit peu?
So, beyond Agnès Varda's explicit explication about what she thinks she's doing, I'm going to suggest beforehand that I think this closing sequence is about many things, but it also does those things. So it is about cinema, friendship, death, life, and the amazing power of her unique style as a documentarian to mix reality and imagination. Importantly, this scene is not about work. It is not about women, overtly. It is not about rural France, overtly. It is not about family, overtly, or not about photography, overtly, which are the other themes of this film. So the last thing I would like to say to introduce the scene is that I just said this is a scene about very heavy things, very deep things, very moving things to human beings, cinema, friendship, death, life. And as is true across the entire film and her larger body of film, it is deceptively simple and even sweet in how she deploys that. And that is her signature style. And that signature style, which is deceptively simple and sweet, is the first thing that's in direct opposition, I would say, to the signature style of men who have also had important lifelong careers in cinema. And because this last scene is a conversation with Godard, overtly, I'm going to just say that she is holding that in conversation with the more celebrated, more attended to, more known styles of great male filmmakers, which tend to be much more showy, much more aggressive, much more cynical.
Forget it, Jake, it's Chinatown.
Than how she performs her cine-écriture, her writing, her unique voice. And because the history of cinema has been primarily written by men about things that men do, we've celebrated a certain hand. And she's not a fighter. And she hasn't been aggressive about that. She's watched it happen onto her, and only late in life has she been rewarded the kinds of rewards and the attention she deserved in Europe and now in the United States with the Academy Award nomination. But the simplicity and the sweetness of her style and of her vision of cinema, life, death, friendship is why it was perhaps easy to overlook or to not give the kind of praise that it was worthy of, and it is what's so exciting about attending to it now.
And more women are becoming directors, and now I see women coming from everywhere and doing strong films and different approach to stories than men, and sometimes as strong but different. I feel proud about that, in a way.